Hey, how's it going, yeah? I can teach you of how to practice drawing manga.
It seems hard. I don't know.
Hard? I also have a penis. Ha ha.
Manga, manga, manga. What the gomi is manga? Manga is comic books from Japan. One of the oldest modern manga comics is New Treasure Island from 1947. The style of manga available that most people read are sci-fi, fantasy, and other sexy, Holy crap, this is hot. When you're the creative type, you just have the urge to draw some manga comics on your own. So why not pull out a pencil and a piece of paper and let your imagination run wild? Oh. Anyways, it's this book called Manga Mania. How to Draw Japanese Comics. Which is a book from Christopher Hart, just like Manga Mania Villains, Manga Mania Bushujo, and Drawing Fantastic Furries. Here's the cover of this book. Words can't describe it. It's just so much activity. Christopher Hart is one amazing artist. I love their facial expressions, which suits the character. Now that's a face of a warrior. Here's the title. Manga Mania. Stands out quite nicely. Bottom, and it states, How to Draw Japanese Comics. Here's the side. And the back. And the back says, Manga Mania. How to Draw Japanese Comics. The manga invasion is in full swing. What accounts for the amazing popularity of Japanese comics? Perhaps it's the unique and instantly recognizable drawing style. Or maybe it's the focus on appealing everyday people rather than on violent superheroes. Whatever it is, manga is here to stay. The only book to provide comprehensive drawing instruction in this style of comic book illustration. Manga Mania, How to Draw Japanese Comics, is a must-have for anyone who loves comics and loves to draw. Published by Watson Guptill Publications. This was printed in 2001. But I got this book for Christmas in 2003. Best gift ever! It's only about 144 pages long. Let's now get into this book. Check out the contents. On page 7 is the introduction.
Years ago, Hollywood discovered manga and brought it to the United States in the form of animated television shows such as Astro Boy, Kimba the White Lion, Gigantor, Speed Racer, and Tubor, the Eighth Man. Today, Hollywood is still mining Japan for animated shows, but with increasing frequency. It is turning comic books into television shows, and television shows into movies, and movies into toy and licensing empires.
On page 9, Manga Basics. Check out the youthful manga head, there's only 6 steps to construct the head. Page 12 and 13, the manga eye, which shows different types of eyes. It is based on different views and emotions. Page 29 is action poses. Baseball boy. Baseball-themed comics are also popular in Japan, a country that loves baseball almost as much as America. Note, how the limbs don't curl into or overlap the body, but stretch outward, creating a feeling of released energy. Speed lines help. But the clear twisting of the body is what makes this pose work. Remember, when drawing action poses, don't go for singles, go for home runs. Here's the rest of the poses with purpose. Page 40, dynamic poses. Now here are 3 different types of poses. First one, this one is weak. This is a neutral pose. There's nothing dynamic about standing on 2 feet with the weight equally distributed. And this one is better. This pose is an improvement because it isn't as flat and symmetrical as the previous one. However, the unexaggerated side pose has the unhappy effect of slimming down the character's physique until he's but a slender reed. And with his feet close together, he doesn't seem to be standing on his ground with any authority. And the last one, dynamic. Now the character appears as he should, full of spirit and energy. Why is this so? When he isn't actually doing anything. Because he's positioned so that the near half of his body appears larger, while the far half becomes smaller as it recedes from the reader. Notice the use of the horizontal vanishing lines, which the artist employs to create a perspective grid on which to draw the character. All parts the character's body, notably shoulders, chest, knees, and feet, recede along these vanishing lines. Page 62, Samurai Fighting Weapons. The most popular fighting weapons of the samurai class were the sword, staff, and spear. Fighting scenes show how posed the samurai were. Their steely calm is evident even the most brutal battle scenes. They have total control over their bodies at all times. Page 72, Light and Shadow, which it teaches you how to make your drawings look more third-dimensional. Here's the trick. If you're wondering what good it'll do to see the shadows cast from these simple shapes rather than from the more complex human figure, consider this. The human head casts the same shadow that an egg casts. Page 116, don't say it, show it. Japanese comics are meant to be read quickly. The panels, guiding the eye uninterrupted from moment to moment, allow the pictures to tell the story whenever possible. Cut down on unnecessary text and let the expressions and actions explain the state of mind of the characters. Here's 2 different styles, Western style, manga style. That's the book. There's so much in this book that I didn't mention. But there's only so much you can fit in one YouTube video. Before I go, here's some manga pictures I've drawn myself. Check it out. Well, that's that. Tell me, what's your favorite manga comics? Also, do you like to draw manga? Let me know. Leave a comment below. Sayonara.